Good morning, guys. Sam Bolton here, and I'm down here today at Knowsley Comic Con. So today, what I'm going to be doing in this short video, I've just been going around, seeing a load of the stuff, maybe get some cosplay photos, maybe see what people are up and selling. So come along with me today, guys, for the short video at Knowsley Comic Con. Come on, let's go have some fun. So guys, I've been hanging around here for around about an hour now. It's going pretty darn well, but I really wanted to know what makes Comic-Con so awesome. So I'm going to go around and ask a few people simple questions, why they think Comic-Con's just amazing. So guys, I've managed to find out my first interview, and I'm with Lord Vader. So Lord Vader, how are you enjoying Knowsley Comic-Con today?
Very well, thank you. It's very good.
Awesome.
Thank you very much. I noticed that there are no Jedi around the area. I've worked enough about wearing them on my shirt, so... Okay, sorry about that. So I assume that today you've come down to say to whether you notice there is a sense in the Force to know whether there's any Jedi around?
No, we cleared the area before we came.
You cleared the area of the Jedi before they came. Just out of curiosity, who initiated Order 66?
Oh. Say that again, sorry.
Who initiated Order 66?
I don't know.
Oh, not sure. I know who. Emperor Palpatine initiated Order 66. Anyway, so gentlemen, is there any questions from you? No?
Let me see your identification.
I don't have any identification.
We don't need to see his identification.
Brilliant, so that means I'm free to go. Thanks, guys. See. All right, I'm going. See ya. Okay, guys, so I'm standing around here with some of the guys from Comic-Con, so we're just going to see what they think of it. So, guys, what's your names, please?
Steve. This is Lewis.
Steve and Lewis. So, guys, just a few quick questions. What makes Comic-Con so awesome?
It's just a good experience, isn't it? Like, people, not many people do stuff like this around here, so it's nice for the kids and that.
Yeah, you guys having a fun day? You're having a great time? So you notice you're dressed up as Batman and the Joker. I'm guessing that's the Heath Ledger Joker.
No, it's the Arkham the Invasion.
Is it the Arkham Joker? I see. So, guys, have you gone to many other conventions, or do you mainly just...
My first one. He's been before, like, it's my first.
Okay, all right, that's awesome. All right, well, thanks very much, guys. I hope you enjoy the rest of your day. Thanks very much. So I'm standing here with the Cox family. So, guys, this is your first Comic-Con, I've heard.
Yeah, first time, yeah, just bringing the boys along.
Okay, so what made you decide to come this year? What makes Comic-Con's this brilliant?
Well, the boys are at that age now where they're really kind of getting into Spider-Man and Batman, and so it was a chance to come along and just have a look around.
You guys having a good time?
Yeah.
Yeah. What's your favourite stuff? So you're dressed up as a Ghostbuster, but do you like other things? So are you a Doctor Who fan? Are you Star Wars fan? What do you like?
Spider-Man.
I love Spider-Man as well. It's my favourite. He's probably my favourite hero.
But the one that I don't have, all of my suits don't fit me.
Oh, I see. Okay. So, guys, do you fancy maybe going to it? Do you think you're going to go to other conventions around the area, or do you think there's going to be any more in the future?
Yeah, no, I think so, yeah, definitely. I think, like I say, just getting an idea of it today. But the guys have already seen plenty of things they like the idea of, so...
And in the next few months, I know that Liverpool Comic-Con's actually coming as well, so do you guys think you may go to that in the future? That's going to be a lot bigger.
Yeah, where are they holding that, do you know?
They're holding it in the exhibition centre in the city.
Oh, okay, yeah, no, definitely. I think I'd like to go along to that.
If you decide to come along, I'll see you there. So guys, thanks very much. Thank you very much for the interview. Have you enjoyed the rest of your day? Okay guys, so I'm now standing here with, what's your names?
Jessica.
Jessica.
So we've got two Jessicas here. So, girls, quick questions. What is it that makes Comic-Con so amazing? What do you really love about Comic-Con?
Everyone likes the same things. Like, you know, it's a place where, like, you always, like, find someone who's got something in common with you. You'll probably meet someone, like, really good. It's great.
Awesome. What do you think?
Uh,
For me, I love the guests, like going to see someone that you've seen on television so many times, and then being able to see them in person. It's just amazing.
So, is this your very first Comic-Con, or have you been to others around the area?
I've only been to three.
You've only been to three?
In the past couple of years, yeah.
I see. And what about you?
I've been to quite a few.
Are you going to go to any in the future? Do you fancy maybe going to Liverpool Comic-Con, maybe Manchester in the future? What do you guys think?
Oh, definitely. As soon as I can afford them, I want to go, yeah.
Yeah, I'm going to Liverpool Comic-Con, and I want to go to Wales.
Is that the Liverpool Comic Con in March?
Yes.
Then I will see you there. I look forward to seeing you. Okay, so thanks very much, girls. I hope you enjoy the rest of your day. Okay, guys, so I'm now standing here with these fine-looking people. So what are your names?
Melanie, Alana,
and Aaron.
And this is Aaron. So, guys, is this your first ever Comic Con that you've ever come to?
No. We've been to Liverpool, Manchester and Wales Comic Con.
I've been to Manchester myself. What is it that actually makes Comic Con amazing? What is it that makes it so cool?
It's the atmosphere.
Yeah.
Everyone's got such a happy, confident, lively atmosphere that makes you happy.
Is it cool that this sort of culture's really growing and growing and growing over the years, and people are becoming more like you guys and having fun like this? Do you think it's awesome?
Yes.
Yeah. If there's any, when they come to this, like first one, and it grows and grows.
Yeah. Yeah. I see. So are you going to go to many more Comic Cons in the future?
The Liverpool one next month, and then
Wales in April.
I will see you then at the Liverpool Comic Con. Hopefully see you around then. Are you having a great day, mate? Awesome. So thanks very much, guys, and we're going to see what else is around. So guys, I'm standing here with Jay. So Jay, it's an absolute pleasure to meet you.
So
I want to ask, what is it about Comic-Con that is just so amazing? What is it about this culture that is so gripping to so many people? What do you think?
I think it's just the brilliant community you get and the creativity from all the people that turn up. They spent hours, you know, working on costumes and all the dealers as well, all the merchants. They've all got this great community spirit with everyone. It's just a great environment to come down and have.
That's amazing. So have you been to many Comic-Cons, or is this your first one?
No, we've done a few. I've been to quite a few as a customer, but this one of my, we've done a couple now with our stall, Geeky Gifts, doing all the action figure photography and things. So that's starting to pick up.
Are you going to be planning to go to many other events in the future? Are you maybe going to Manchester, to Liverpool, any other Comic-Cons?
I'm going to Liverpool as a paying customer. I'm just enjoying myself at that one, but we've got a few in the near future, like the World Comic Con that we're going to be having in store.
Is that going to be the Comic Con at the Exhibition Centre in March?
Yes.
Then the good news is I will see you there, because I'm going to be there. So I want to wish you a really happy day, and I hope that you enjoy the rest of your day.
You too.
Thank you very much.
All the best.
So that about wraps it up. So we're just going to scoot around and see what awesome stuff is actually going around here at Comic Con, and we're going to take you along. Okay, guys, so I'm standing here with Dominic Pace, the one-of-a-kind bounty hunter from the TV series The Mandalorian. So it's an absolute honour to meet you. It's great to meet you.
Absolutely.
So welcome to Comic-Con. Is this your first one here?
First one here, first time in the UK. Really happy to be here. We start a 21-city tour in the United States. The success of The Mandalorian, I mean, just little side characters like myself are able to have this kind of a tour just because of the popularity of the show.
I've just started getting into The Mandalorian myself, and I'm absolutely loving it. It's a fantastic show. Is there any sort of secrets that you can tell me about what's coming up soon? Or
For season two, no, not at all. But just for those who haven't seen it, I mean, just enjoy every moment. Yeah. Every single episode in and of itself. just has its own level of entertainment. They use an LED screen, just state-of-the-art technology, which really brings filmmaking to the next level.
Yeah.
So, I mean, even with season two now, understanding this, you realize that they can more or less just go anywhere in the universe, and it's easy for the producers and the directors to be able to transport us all there.
The Star Wars galaxy is just amazing, isn't it? It's just massive and massive, and just keeps growing and growing and growing. So what is it? I just want to ask one last question. What is it about Comic-Con that is so awesome? Why do you think this sort of culture is growing and growing and growing so much more bigger?
I think people love escapism. I think that ultimately is the great thing. You know, look, we all have it hard in life. You know, the reality of life is sometimes harsh. And I think the beauty of filmmaking, the beauty of cinema, are these comic book movies, are they also just comic books even before cinema, to where we're able to escape.
Yeah.
So I just think it's everyone sharing in their level of escapism for things that are all about positivity, goodness, and creativity. And you can never go wrong with that.
Awesome. Well, thank you very much for having this chat. I really do appreciate it. Thank you. And you have a wonderful day.
Thank you very much.
Okay, guys, so I'm standing here with voice actor Marc Silk. So
technically, you're sitting.
Okay, technically I'm sitting. Marc, it's an absolute pleasure to meet you.
Thank you.
So, what brings you today to Knowsley Comic Con? Tell me, what brings you here?
I got invited to come up and just meet a whole bunch of people. There's day to day, I'm a voice actor.
Yeah.
So it's my voice here in a stack of movies and games and TV shows, cartoons. But yeah, we're in the magic room over there, just saying hi to people.
And now we're out here doing an interview. So, have you been to many Comic Cons around the area, or do you just do this one? Do you do any kind?
It's the first time I've been to this part of the world. First time I've done a Comic Con in Liverpool. I do a lot of Comic Cons around the UK and in New York, and but this first time here.
Awesome. And are you planning to go to any more around the future? Are you maybe going to Liverpool in March, or are you not going to go there?
This is my Liverpool experience now, but I've got other stuff planned during the year.
Okay.
I'm off to New York in April.
Oh, that's brilliant. That's awesome. And that's New York Comic Con. So, what is it about Comic Con that you think really attracts people? What do you think that makes it so brilliant to these type of people?
I like just being able to. For me, I mean, I work in this world, but I like just be able to hang out and meet people whose work I like.
Yeah.
So it's a chance to meet other actors or performers that you get a kick out of their work on shows.
Yeah.
And to chat about your loves. You make it's really sociable. I mean, you make a stack of new friends being at these kind of things. But also. I'm a fan of other stuff, so I'm next to Gareth from Torchwood, and then round there there's a whole these things you tend to see. There'll be loads of merchandise or props or cool artwork or bits and pieces that you just want for your collections at home. So I've just seen a bunch in there that I want to take home. I've come as a guest to sign and stuff and meet people, but I like chatting about what they do, what they get up to. Sorry, microphone, and the. There's a really great. I'm a big fan of Jaws. There's a really good Funko Jaws thing in there that I might have to put in my case
back from the train.
Yeah.
I see. And just before you go, you are a voice actor of several shows. You do Pingu. You've done Danger Mouse. You've done Star Wars.
Yeah.
You've done. Can I ask? Can I have some of those impressions?
Sure, buddy. We got Johnny Bravo, man, for Cartoon Network UK. We got Crikey, Chief Crumbs, Danger Mouse. There's a great show called GoJet. It's on CBeebies. I'm the voice of Grandmaster Glitch. I'll get you, no jitters. Right now, in fact, today, this morning on ITV, is the first part of the finale of Thunderbirds Are Go. So I'm the completely handsome Captain Wayne Rigby with beautiful, freshly baked eyebrows at 5, 4, 3, 12, 8. Thunderbirds Are Go. And we've got, there's a great show for a while back called Fifi and the Flower Tots, where I'm the voice of Bumble and Slugsy, and there's Pingu and Star Wars. I worked with George Lucas on Star Wars, so I'm the voice. There's a load of stuff. There's stacks of them. If you for more information, I keep knocking this microphone. It's a good job I don't work in studios, otherwise, you know, I wouldn't know how to handle microphones.
So thank you ever so much for talking to me. It's an absolute pleasure.
If you want to find out more about the full list of them, I'm at Marc Silk on social media. MarcSilk.
Awesome.
So, we should go have a go in there.
Yeah, we should actually.
There's a big like soft play area in there. You go to the next video. But it sounds like you're going to go and play on the big slide. It's really cool.
And just before we do that, guys, this is where I officially sign off. This has been an awesome day. Thank you ever so much, Marc, for talking to me. It's an absolute pleasure. Yeah, we're going to go and play in the playroom in a little bit. But guys, thank you ever so much for watching the short video about Knowsley Comic Con. Please don't forget to like and subscribe to my YouTube channel. If you guys want to follow me on social media, I'm on all of these websites down below me. He does.
I really do.
Yes, he does. Okay, and so guys, once again, thank you ever so much for watching this video, and I will see you soon in more videos in the future. So take care.